top 8 answers on the board. Name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy. Bird. Bird.
Cat.
Cat. Corinne, name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
A dog?
Good answer.
I mean, like how? Give me an example.
Like growling.
No, I mean, show me what you mean. You trying to say. You and Kyle, you with your husband, Kyle, and you want to sound sexy.
Like, her.
That do it for you?
Come on now, Steve.
Dog.
That was hot.
Kyle, name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
I'm gonna have to go with a panther.
Good answer.
Let me hear the sexy panther, Kyle.
Give him my best shot.
Yeah, that's good right there.
What's up there?
Hey. Yeah. Woo! Panther! Yeah. Kaylee, okay. Name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make a voice sound sexy.
I'm gonna say a gorilla.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Let me hear that sexy gorilla. That wild gorilla.
I told ya.
Yeah. It's that jungle love there, girl. Kyle, name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
Tiger.
All right. Tiger.
Good answer. I was ready. I knew it was coming.
Oh, well, let's have it. So y'all just out the house, all hell break loose in there.
Okay, it's the Amazon.
Y'all got kids yet?
No, sir.
No, you can't have kids right now. Yeah, y'all gotta work all these noises out before you had them kids. You cannot be in there with all that. Tiger. Alex?
Yes.
Name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
I'm gonna go with a cheetah.
All right, we got a cheetah that's trying to sound sexy. Alex, hit it. Yeah, that was the worst one. Cause you're like, cheetah! Only one strike. Oh, we back here again. Back down here in the love nest. See, this is a love nest down here. This jungle love up here. We down here in the little love nest. Corinne, name an animal that a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
A wolf.
Oh. Yeah. The wolf. All right, let's hear it.
Ooh!
Hey, Kyle, did you just hold your heart? Wolf. All right, Kyle, we got 2 strikes. Meet your family can steal. Give me an animal woman imitates, make a voice sound sexy.
I'm gonna have to go with a snake.
Okay, good answer.
And Kyle, I like that one right there. Let's hear it. That boy was good. That boy said, he had a little ripple in it too. Snake. One answer left, clear the board. Name an animal a woman imitates in an attempt to make a voice sound sexy. Oh.
Going back to jungle love, an elephant.
Yeah, boy. Waiting on you, Kaylee.
I can't. Let's hear you. Just do my best.
Yeah, listen. Name an animal that a woman imitates in an attempt to make her voice sound sexy.
We're gonna go with a lion, Steve.
The lion! All right, ladies, top five answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women. You love your fiancé, but hate the ring. What do you do?
Give it back.
Give it back.
Hey.
Have them fix it. Have them change it.
Have them fix it. Pass the play.
We're gonna play. Okay.
Brian, we talked to 100 women, buddy. You love your fiance, but hate the ring. What you do?
Steve, I'm gonna say that you tell him no.
Good answer.
You tell him no. I don't like this question, man. Are you serious? A guy, you love him, but you hate the ring. You dump him. Karen, talk to 100 women. You love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do you do?
Tell him you hate it.
Tell him you hate it. Hey, Erica, we asked 100 women, you love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do you do?
You keep it because you love him.
You yeah. keep it because you love him. Thank you to the 40 decent women out there. You hang in there, fellas. All right, here we go. Talk to 100 women. You love your feel. Are you married?
I'm not.
Oh, this is gonna be perfect. You've met this man. He's your fiance. You absolutely adore him. He's a wonderful man. He gives you a ring. You hate the ring. Jenna, what do you do?
Well, Steve, I think I would just tell my friend and not say anything to him.
Tell your friends and not say anything to him. Tell your friends and don't say nothing to him. Only one strike, Savannah.
Okay.
You love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
I just don't wear it. I don't wear the ring.
Yeah.
Don't wear it. One answer left, two strikes, or family can steal. 100 women, you love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
You pretend that you lost it.
You pretend that you lost it. Gentlemen, top eight answers on the board. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A job.
A job. Good.
Money.
Money. 10.3 million. All right, pass and play.
Play.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Let's play. Greg, what do you do for a living, man?
Man, I'm a teacher coach in Hammond, Louisiana, and I have a wonderful wife, Macy, I've been married to for 2 years. But my, you know, proudest moment is that I'm a cat dad, proud father of a cat, a wonderful cat named Lucy. She's beautiful, gorgeous, fluffy. Everything about her is wonderful, Steve.
That's my grandchild, yeah.
Now, Mary Beth, you said that the cat is your grandchild.
It's my grandchild. He told me that's all I'm getting, so I just worship her and take pictures and talk to her.
You're highly disappointed in that.
No, Steve.
Never,
no.
Never.
She has a dog, too.
I have
my little baby.
I have a dog, grand dog, and another grand dog. They said that's all I get, so.
Of course, she never brings up grandbabies.
So this is your mother.
Yes.
Your mother, your mother.
Uh-huh.
Your mother.
Uh-huh.
And none of you want kids?
Not yet.
I do, but I'm waiting for the perfect man.
Waiting on the perfect man.
Perfect man, they all married. I'm still looking.
No, well, the perfect man is coming back and we know not when.
Okay, you're right, you're right. You're right on that one. You're right.
You might want to just look into one of these dudes down here on Earth. All right, let's go. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
Hair. Sorry, son.
That's why you ain't got no grandkids. You know, it's a little mean stuff like that, Mary Beth. You know, God don't like ugly, Mary Beth. Now, it's gonna be another 3 years before you have them grandkids. 3 more years, just said, oh, that dating man got some hair. Now, dating man got some hair. Yeah, well, look at number one, son. Hey, Marianne.
Hey.
Good, good. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
Muscles.
Muscles. Well. Looking for Mr. Perfect. Hey, Alexandra. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A nice butt.
A nice butt. Kevin, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing good.
All right, buddy, a woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A man that was mature.
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 All right, Greg, we got to slow down. We got 2 strikes now. We got to pull something out. Broadest family can steal. Woman might put in a date now, and I only want to date men who have what?
A car, Steve.
I only want to date men who's got a car. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. All right, family, here we go. Here's your chance. A woman might put in her date now, and I only want to date men who have what?
I was gonna say a house, Steve.
This is a house. Number 7.
Integrity.
6.
Humor. 5.
See, I got all that.
No, you do, you do.
All that. I just ain't got no damn hair. That's all I'm missing is some damn hair. Number 4, let's see if I got this.
Brain. Yeah.
Number 3. Let's get it on, y'all. Let's play Feud. Give me Paul. Give me Dave. Top 6 answers on the board. Grandpa says, Grandma used to like to make love. Now she likes to make what?
Sleep.
Sleep.
Yeah. Food.
Food. Pass the play. Let's go.
How are you, Steve?
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Damn, if I ain't looking at my uncle. Well, this ain't a family member right here. I just like my cousin, Tim. Hey, Tim. How you doing, man?
Good, good, good. Steve, good to see you.
Good to see you. What do you do?
My name's Paul. I'm a food server at Spago at the Bellagio in Las Vegas. The fascinating thing is at least three times a night, somebody tells me that I look like a famous, handsome celebrity.
I know. As soon as I walked over here, I said, I'll be damned. Yeah, introduce everybody, Paul.
All right, Steve. This is my big brother, Scott. This is my beautiful sister, Sandra. This is my anointed brother, Michael. And my very wise and oldest brother, Kevin. Yeah. Welcome to the show.
Let's play some food. Yes. Grandpa says grandma used to like make love. Now she likes to make what?
Excuses.
Excuses. Yeah. Yeah, you know why they ain't up there about grandma? Because it ain't just grandma. Miss Sandy, grandpa says grandma used to make love. Now she likes to make what?
Quilts.
Huh?
Quilts.
Oh, I'm sorry. Quilts. Grandpa says grandma used to make love, now she likes to make what?
Puzzles.
Good answer.
Yeah.
It's up there.
Kevin. Two strikes, be careful. Scosi family can steal. Grandpa says grandma used to like to make love, now she like to make what?
Memories.
You know that's good, Steve. Good answer.
Oh, man. That's such a good answer, Kevin. Oh, my God. You're the stick man at the crap table. You wait till your buddies see this when they laugh.
Hey, little sexy. Grandma making memories.
Memories. Grandpa says grandma used to like make love. Now she likes to make what?
Steve, we're gonna go with drama.
Drama.
Yeah. Argument. Yeah.
Number six.
Eight hearts.
Four. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Cup.
A cup.
A wine glass.
Pass the play. We're gonna play. Let's go. All right, Reggie, talk to 100 women. Name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Like the punch bowl, the glass.
Damn.
Punch bowl. It depends on the size.
Come on, man. Yeah. Yeah. Love you. The damn punch bowl. Yeah. The punch bowl. Reggie, we asked 100 women, name a kind of glass you could fit one of your breasts into.
A martini glass.
A martini glass. All right, only one strike, Ken. This gonna be good. See, y'all got a lot of education over here. Ken, yes. Hang in there, man. We asked 100 women, name a kind of glass you could fit one of your breasts into?
A tumbler.
A tumbler?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. A tumbler! All right, Willie.
All right.
This is where we're gonna find out a lot about you, Willie, because you're a really educated man, nuclear physics. Yeah. This ain't really down your alley at all, so this is gonna be a really good answer. 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Shot glass.
That's long.
A shot. Oh, that's so good. A shot glass. Kathy, 100 women, 2 strikes. Be careful, Schmidt family. Can still name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
A flower vase. A vase. A vase.
A vase. We ask 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
We're a beer drinking family, so a beer glass, beer mug.
A beer mug. Number 6. Top 7 answers on the board. Fill in the blank. The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
IV.
IV.
Checkup.
Checkup. Tanya?
A spanking.
Spanking. Dan.
Hearing test.
A hearing test.
A pill.
A pill.
Yeah.
A pill. Sarah. Oh,
take their temperature.
Take the temperature.
Good answer.
Hey, Veronica.
It's so nice to meet you, Steve. We were looking forward to this all our lives.
Really?
Well, I don't know, but like we were really looking forward to this.
No, no, I like, just lie to me. I like that, just stay with me. All of our lives, yeah. What do you do for a living?
Okay, so I'm so blessed because I get to be a full-time mommy to my spirited child, Hannah Elizabeth, and I am happily married to my a spicy husband, Santiago. I love you, babe.
You got a husband named Santiago.
And you have to say it like that, Santiago.
I know Santiago. Something got to be happening at this house. Santiago. Yeah. All right, introduce everybody.
Okay, well, here is my tenacious sister, Tanya. And then my incredible cousin, Irene. My magnificent sister, Magdalena. And last but not least, my bodacious cousin, Brittany.
That's pretty good. Well, let's play the game.
I'm next.
All right. No. All right, let's go.
Let's do this.
Ma'am.
Yes.
The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A bath.
A bath.
Good.
Brittany.
Hi.
The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A blood pressure check.
Blood pressure. Round of after the nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them what?
A urine sample?
A urine sample? All right, we got two strikes, Tanya. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
Immunizations.
Immunizations. Congratulations. Two strikes. We got to be careful. Irene, hi.
Yes, hi.
The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A foot rub.
A foot rub.
Magdalena.
You know, if you give me a chance. Jeez, as soon as I say Magdalena. You done got tired of people messing your name up.
Maybe.
Okay. Well, other family can steal. Nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A pillow.
A pillow. The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
Pulse check.
Check your pulse.
Good answer.
Number seven.
Ben!
Number five.
Isaac!
Top seven answers on the board. We ask 100 married men, in heaven, what do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
Money.
Money.
Family.
Family. Rondell.
Peace and quiet.
Peace and quiet. Charnice, we talked to 100 married men. In heaven, I'm just say this once to everybody. This is for 100 married men. One time, 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope you finally get to have all to yourself?
A TV.
TV, all to yourself. Yeah. Date 100 men. You get to heaven, what do you finally hope to have all to yourself?
Like, you know, there's this little man room, like...
See, that's what we're talking about. The man room. That's a man room. Yeah. A man room. Oh, all right, Roger, you probably been wanting to say this to your family for a long time. Your wife is here. The kids is here. You probably ain't never said that to them, because you ain't want to hurt them. But they here. You finally get to have this all to your damn self. Go ahead, Roger.
My own bedroom. All to myself.
I understand what you mean by that. Your own bedroom. Own bedroom. Yeah!
Good job, Dad.
Shabree, talk to 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope you finally get to have? All to yourself. This is mine.
Your own bathroom, Steve.
Man. My own bathroom.
Good answer.
That's a big thing.
Good answer.
One strike. Rondell, you in heaven. What do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
My refrigerator.
That's a big boy answer right there. It's Rondell. Rondell wants his own damn refrigerator. Don't nobody get nothing in here. All this mine, homie. Rondell want his own. All he hams in here, all them hams is mine. Hey God, when Rondell get to heaven, he want his own refrigerator. Shawnice, 100 married men in heaven, what do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
I'm gonna go with closet space.
Now, we know that even in heaven, we ain't gonna get that, so. Closet space. Well, well, well. Yeah, look whose turn it is again. Guess we gonna be down here for 5 minutes. Let me go on, take a seat. Watch you play these little reindeer games. We got 2 strikes, Jada. The family can steal. Don't worry, it's gonna be a minute for us. We ask 100 married men in heaven, what do you finally get to have all to yourself? Talk to 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope to finally have all to yourself?
The silver fox says a recliner. Yeah.
Yeah. The silver fox wants his own lazy boy recliner. Number 6. In heaven? All right, guys, here we go. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something belonging to his lady love that a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
Her underwear.
Good answer.
Not me. Not me, but that's what came up in my head.
Really? No. Not you,
not me.
But that's what came up in your head. Yeah. Nothing else on the board. 7 clear, board wide open. That's the one you came up with, and you're trying to convince us that not you.
Not me, no. I plead the 5th.
Yeah, you don't have to plead the 5th. It's up here. Let's go. You got the panties on. Oh!
Yeah. I got the power.
Oh, you got the power? Really?
Trained him very well.
Trained him very well.
I'm still pleading the 5th.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Name something belonging to his lady that a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
Her perfume?
Good answer.
Perfume. Cap, name something belonging to his lady a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
Her blanket.
Her blanket?
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Her blanket. Oh. Anthony, name something belonging to his lady a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
Her robe.
Maybe I don't. Maybe it's just a size difference between me and my wife. I can't wear nothing she got. Her robe. Oh. Karina, name something belonging to his lady that a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
I'm gonna go with lip balm.
Jesus.
Good answer.
You don't get in here well, I can't put no lip balm on these puppies here. Steve got on Marjorie lip balm. Oh, here we go. Oh, Jesse, I knew you probably know all these. Jesse, we got two strikes. Gibson family could steal, but not what you answered. Come on, man. Name something else you done wore hers that a man might wear so he can feel close to Karina.
Her bra.
Good answer. Good answer.
Wear the underwear, might as well wear the bra, right?
How do you snap it? How do you snap a bra? And it's back there. Bra. Is this what millennials are doing? Y'all putting on bras and panties while we're on? Brian, two strikes. Gibson's can steal. Name something belonging to his lady that a man might wear so he can feel close to her.
Wear her bag? Her purse?
Good answer.
The purse. Name something belonging to his lady that a man might wear so he could feel close to her.
We're gonna say a piece of her jewelry.
A piece of her jewelry. Number four.
Star.
Two. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women, if it were up to your man, and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Nothing.
Nothing.
A bikini.
A bikini. Don't worry about that. Listen to me. Don't worry about that. Uh-huh. Sometimes a good answer just ain't up yet. Yeah. Should have been number one.
We're gonna play.
Yes, ma'am. All right. We asked 100 women, if up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Sexy high heels.
Yes. High heels. We talked to 100 women, if it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Sexy lingerie.
Sexy lingerie. Yeah. All right now, Miss Margarita.
Yeah, Steve.
Well, come on, Ivana.
Yep.
All right, we asked 100 women, if it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Short shorts.
Short shorts. Julie, talk to 100 women. If it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Well, it won't be up to my husband, but because I wouldn't do it, but a sexy little dress.
Sexy little dress. Julie, you wouldn't do that for your man?
So he gets to see the high heels on TV today. That's about all he's gonna get. Sorry, honey. Maybe I'll wear them home for him.
Wow.
But he's happily married, Steve, so that's what's important.
All right, you ready?
Yes.
We ask 100 women, if it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
I'm gonna say a cat suit.
Woo. Last time you heard somebody say you got a cat suit on. You got the cat suit on. All right, we got two strikes. Gotta be careful. If it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
I think I would wear fishnet stockings.
Fishnets. Fishnet stockings. Oh. 100 women, if it were up to your man and it isn't, what would you wear every day?
Steve, we gonna say perfume.
Perfume.
Oh.
6. 5. I gotta start coming to rehearsal. Yeah. Top 6 answers on the board. Steve Harvey just knocked on your front door. What do you hope he wants?
Me.
Huh? They said, what do you mean by that?
Knocking to come see me as a person. Knocking to come see me, visit me. Pay me a visit.
Come see me.
Steve, I'm gonna say be put on the show.
To put you on the show.
I'm gonna play Steve.
Let's go.
Steve Harvey.
Hey, Zach.
Zach, nice to meet you.
Zach, I like that tie, man.
Thank you.
What do you do, Zach?
So I'm a 29-year-old attorney who works in public policy in Boston.
Zach, you got a couple fans out here, man.
Oh, thank you.
They said, is he single? He said, yeah. They went, hey, Zach. All right, Zach, so you stay by yourself?
No, I'm actually dating.
You know, this story is going the other way, Zach. All right, Zach, so nice lady?
It's actually a him.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. Walked into that one. Yeah, just give me a hug, man. Come on. All right, well, let's go. Let's meet everybody. So, introduce everybody.
Let me introduce my big fat Greek family to you. I have my sister from the same mister, Chloe. I have my spicy cousin, Julia. Hi. My Thea Kula, so Thea means aunt in Greek, Angela. And my brother-in-law, Tofi.
Yay! Yeah.
Chloe?
Hello.
I just walked up, knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
My number.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, the old Steve Harvey is back. Hope he wants my number. Julia, I just knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
Alcohol.
Your mama am gonna take you out of that school. You keep up. Want some alcohol? Angela, I just knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
I hope that you are there to offer me a job, Steve.
Offer you a job.
That's all right.
Toffee, we got 2 strikes. We gotta be careful, buddy. The Allen family can steal. I just walked up to your front door. What do you hope I want?
You're gonna give me money.
Give me some money. All right, Zach, we got 2 strikes, buddy. We gotta be careful. The Allen family can steal. I just walked up, knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
You're gonna send me on vacation, Steve.
I'm sending you on vacation. Just knocked on your front door. What do you hope he wants?
Giving me a new car, Steve.
Gonna give you a new car. Number 6. Top 7 answers on the board. Here we go.
Name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
They're stubborn.
Stubborn.
Body shape.
Body shape. Let's go, Jason. Man. That's my little dude right there. Henry, name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
They're both pretty loud. Good answer. Ooh.
They're both loud.
Yes. Yes.
Trey, something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant got in common.
They got some big old ears, Steve.
Big old ears. Mom, name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They got the same appetite, Steve. She likes to eat.
Big girl gotta eat.
She likes to eat.
Big girl gotta eat. Dave, name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
I'm gonna say, Steve, some big old feet.
Some big feet.
Big feet.
Jason? All right, man.
I don't know about this one.
Yeah, I know. Straight out of high school, you got to dig deep. How old are you, Jason?
I'm 14. I'm about to turn 15 in about 4 days. I don't know.
Yeah, that's what you always say. You know, whenever you ain't 18, you give your age and the next one up. Yeah. I'm 14, about to be 15. I'm 16 on the way. I'm 16 and 3/4. Yeah. All right, name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They take big deuces.
Take big old bumps.
That's all I got.
That's deep.
They take big deuces. Henry got 2 strikes. Anthony family could steal. Name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They both got a big old nose.
They both got a big old nose. Yes. Trey, 2 strikes. Other family could steal. Something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
I don't know if it's true, but they probably both smell. Oh. They got nasty smell.
They both smell.
Wow.
Oh. All right, let's name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
Steve, we're gonna say she had really rough skin.
She has rough skin. It's bad if a woman discovers a nude photo on her man's phone. It's worse if it's a photo of who?
A man.
A man, ooh. Yeah, we got a problem now, partner. Man.
The president.
The president.
Steve.
Hey, Landon, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Steve.
What do you do, brother?
I'm a pastor and a church planter.
Church planter?
Yes, sir. I plant churches.
What do you mean by that, Landon?
Brand new churches.
New churches. Yeah,
oh, you
get
start churches.
Right, I help pastors
okay, well, hey,
get started.
Hey, say that, Landon.
I help pastors get started in ministry.
Talking about you planting churches. I'm sitting here, I mean, you dig a hole and stick some stuff together. You help start churches.
I help start churches.
Yeah,
I
counselors help. And mentors
right,
pastors.
Right, right. Start
I got
new,
you.
Right.
What we call that's planting, like planting seeds.
Yes.
That's I got it now. I got you, Landon. Good job, baby. Bad if a woman discovers a nude photo on her man's phone. It's worse if it's a photo of who?
I'd say himself.
Of himself. Lydia, what do you do?
Well, my husband and I run a construction company for my home.
Oh, y'all in construction?
I'm in construction. I have a degree in construction management.
Really?
Yes, yes, sir.
Well, you got to be the best looking construction management person I've ever seen. Most construction works big, ugly ass men. Well, bet they a little surprised when they see you walk in.
A little bit. Yeah. A little bit.
But you handle it, though, don't you?
I handle it all.
Get right up. What? All right, Lydia, it's bad if a woman discovers a nude photo on a man's phone. It's worse if it's a photo of who?
Her sister.
Uh-oh. Come on.
Your sister. Yeah. Rachel, it's bad if a woman discovers a nude photo on a man's phone. It's worse if that photo is who?
His mistress.
This mistress.
Oh. That's a good answer.
No, that's a real good answer. I don't know how that ain't up
there. Come
on, Mom. Okay. All right, Miss Ida, we got two strikes. Got to be careful. Henderson family can steal.
His old girlfriend.
His old girlfriend. And two strikes, Henderson's can steal. Bad woman got a nude picture on a man's phone. It's worth if it's a photo of who?
His neighbor.
Okay.
His neighbor.
All right.
It's bad if a woman discovers a nude photo on her man's phone. It's worse if it's a photo of who?
Her mother.
His mother.
Her mother. Number six.
His mom.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Lord.
Mother, mama. I'm sorry, that's a bad moment, man. I'm sorry. Number three. Name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
A bigger house.
A bigger house.
A better job.
A better job. We're gonna keep it. Alan, how you doing, man? What's up, the basketball tie?
We're kind of a basketball family.
Really?
Steve. Yep. I coached basketball for 39 years, just retired in April.
Really? Yeah. Yep. Do you know, Alan, I've often been asked if I wasn't doing this, what I would do. I would want to be a high school basketball coach.
It's living the dream.
Oh, man. Okay. Did your son, you have something to do with it too?
So I'm coaching at Division III college in Wisconsin as well, UW-Platteville.
Really? Yeah. What about you, Tanner?
I coach high school basketball in Wapaka, Wisconsin.
Really?
Yep.
Oh, this really is a basketball family. Well, Alan, introduce everybody, buddy.
Well, this is my son, Keegan. My daughter, who is our biggest basketball fan, Logan. My other son, Tanner. And basketball mom, Sue. Yay!
Come on, let's get some. Name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
I swear to God, this is not me.
Boy.
Spouse,
huh?
Girlfriend.
Really?
I have a great girlfriend. So this is not me. This is what everyone else would say.
Well, I'm just answering you. Okay. Right.
No. This
no,
is 100
it is. No, it's
that.
Your answer. No, Keegan, this is your answer.
She's out there.
She's out there.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. You're so stupid.
That's why I had to say that.
Keegan, the hell'd you say that for? Keegan, listen to me, man. Your dad could have told you. Sometimes you gotta take an ex. Keegan, now, here's the other thing, Keegan. This has got to be up there.
I know.
Because If it ain't up there and she out there.
I know. It's got to be one. What do you mean? If two other people said yeah, this, that's really true.
Yeah, if only two people said it, you're yeah. dead. This has to be the number
I
one.
I know.
His girlfriend or spouse. Boy, that's the only thing saved you, baby. Woo. She's probably out there clapping, too. Where is she? Raise your hand. Stand up, please. Yeah. Boy, you all out your league. Boy, you went way up when you got that one right there.
I said the same thing.
You said the same
yeah.
thing?
She could do better.
She could do better. Damn. His daddy said, damn, she could do better. All right, Logan, name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
A car.
A car.
Yeah, good answer, Logan. Oh.
Tanner, I love this question. Name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
I'm gonna say his friends.
You deserve better friends. That was actually a good answer. Sue, name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
Bank account. Oh. Savings account.
Yeah, bank money. Oh. All right, Alan, we got to pull it together. We got two strikes. Name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
A better wardrobe.
A better wardrobe. Yeah. Yeah. Name something you have. Two strikes. Let's be careful. But your mother thinks you deserve better.
Again, not myself.
Oh, boy. I love this dude right here. Go ahead. What you got?
A better physique.
Yeah. Moms really don't care.
There's a lot of answers already up there.
Yeah. Moms love us regardless.
That's true.
Yeah. Better physique. Oh. Name something you have, but your mother thinks you deserve better.
I would say attitude.
Attitude. Ladies, top eight answers on the board. Here we go. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
Cat.
Cat. Woo! Pass the point.
We're playing, Steve.
Sanam, name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
Dog. A dog.
A dog. Dog. Wow. Neil, just whatever you want to say now. It's wide open now. You couldn't have told me a dog was going to be up there. Not that, no. Name an animal women actually like being compared to.
I'll say a lion.
Oh, yeah, it's up there. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Lion. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
A sparrow?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hey. Why not? Dog is on the damn board. I'm done. Sparrow. I'm telling y'all, once dog is up there, hey, man, Arun, name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
I'm gonna go with fish, Steve.
Like a little mermaid.
All right, we only got one strike, Nisha. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
I'm gonna go with bunny.
A bunny. A bunny. That's a great answer.
Thank you.
Because dog is up there. Two strikes, you gotta be careful. Sawney family can steal. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
A horse.
Horse.
Steve, we're gonna say fox.
Fox. Number eight. Five.
Cheetah.
Two.
Cougar.
Top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Pants.
Huh?
My pants.
In your pants. In your pants.
My nose.
Your nose. Pass the point.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Yeah. Miss Shelley?
Yes.
Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Well, I'm gonna have to say my booty.
Shayla, I'm uncomfortable now. Shayla, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in. Just Jesus.
I'm gonna say my mouth.
Your mouth. Kristen, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Steve, I don't want anybody to stick their fingers in my food.
Oh, yeah. In my food, yeah. Hey, Miss Barbara. I'm about to just apologize to you right now. I'm just reading what's on the card. Matter of fact, could you read that for me, please? Just read it yourself.
Out loud?
Yes, out loud.
Name please. Something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Okay, thank you. Could you answer that right into there, please?
Eyes.
In your eyes.
Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Thank you.
Ooh, this is a toughie. I'm going to say my wallet.
My wallet. Miss Shelley.
Okay. Well, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in. I'm gonna say my private parts.
The private parts. Shayla, now anything you say is safe. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
All right, let's hope it's up there. My belly button.
Good answer, Taylor. Good answer, Taylor.
Belly button. I'm doing it all different ways. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Your ears.
Your ears. Ladies, top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
Butt.
Butt, all right.
Butt.
Boy, you just learning all kind of stuff today, Jesse. The other day was how to kiss better. Now you done found out where you need to be biting. In the butt. Heather?
Lips.
Lips. Pass the point.
We're gonna play. We're gonna play.
Name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
The neck.
Bite on that neck. Tanya, how you doing today?
Great.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
The ear?
Yeah.
Yes. The ear. Yes. Heath, you the troublemaker in the family, so this ought to be good. Come on, Heath. Name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
Steve, you gotta take a little nibble on those private parts.
I told you, this is a little troublemaker in the family right here. He says, nibble on the private parts. Hello, Holly Ann.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm good. How
good
are
to
you?
See you again.
You too.
Name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
The tongue.
You got it. Good.
All right, now, little Holly. Yeah. You married, ain't you?
Yeah.
Oh. Your husband here?
He's not.
He ain't.
I nibble on his
turn. Oh, do you? Oh, do you now? What does your husband do for a living?
He's in pharmacy school.
Oh, pharmacy school. Yeah. Oh, so
he numbs it up before. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Yeah, little Holly, you just letting it all hang out now. He numbs it up for me. I just be just a chewing away. All right, Holly Ann. His tongue. All right, Heather, we got two strikes. Gotta be careful. Sanchez family can still name a part of your lover's body it's okay to gently bite.
We're gonna go with nipples. For sure.
Nipples. Two strikes, gotta be careful. Sanchez family can steal. Give me a part of your lover's body, it's okay to gently bite.
The cheek.
The cheek. Part of your lover's body, it's okay to gently bite.
Foot.
The foot.
For those with feet fetish. Feet fetish.
The foot. Number five. This This is stupid. Point value is a double. Top five answers on the board. Name an animal's poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
A rabbit.
Yeah. Rabbit. Name an animal's poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
I'm gonna say a deer.
Yeah, that is a deer. Steven, animal's poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
Maybe an antelope?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Antelope. Yeah. An animal whose poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
Steve almost said coyote.
Coyote. We got two strikes. Just be careful now. Bobek family can steal.
A hamster.
A hamster. Got two strikes. Bobek family can steal. An animal whose poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
I think a dog.
Yeah, come on. It could be there. You never know.
Not my dog. I wish it was raisinettes.
Small dog. Small dog.
His is more like hot pudding. Small dog. An animal whose poop you might mistake for raisinettes.
All right, we got some of them in Chicago. Rat!
Rat. Top eight answers on the board. Name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she gets tired of
the pool boy.
Pool boy. Name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she gets tired of the pool boy.
The delivery driver.
The delivery driver.
Play.
Yeah, way to complete the sentence, Coulter. Sherman, name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she gets tired of the pool boy.
The gardener.
The gardener. Patrina?
Uh-huh.
Name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she gets tired of the pool boy.
Her boss.
Her boss.
Good answer.
Sherman, brother, name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she get tired of the pool boy.
Well, if she gets really desperate, she might look at the plumber, Steve.
The plumber. Sit up now. Sit up in your seats. Put an arch in your back. It gets good. Hey, Leah.
Hey, Uncle Steve.
Name someone that a housewife might turn her attention to if she get tired of the pool boy.
The garbage man.
The garbage man.
Soon as we rinse him off, it's gonna be me and that damn garbage man. Come on. Come on, Mr. Funky. Name someone a housewife might turn her attention to if she get tired of pool boy.
The neighbor.
The neighbor. Sherman, somebody a housewife might turn her attention to if she get tired of pool boy. We got two strikes, Braziers can steal.
She kind of rich. She probably got a butler, Steve. The butler.
Probably got a butler. She rich, got a butler. I think some of the housewives might turn her attention to if she gets tired of pool boy.
We're gonna go with her personal trainer.
Her personal trainer. Number eight. Okay. Okay. Number seven. Six.
He's a boy,
five. Top eight answers on the board, guys. Here we go. Name something men do that can turn any girlfriend into a psycho girlfriend.
Cheat on her.
Cheat on her, yes. Yes. Cheat.
You gotta play.
We gonna play, Steve?
We gonna play. Miss Sharon, name something men do that could turn any girlfriend into a psycho girlfriend.
Maybe drink too much?
Drink too much.
Good answer. Good answer.
Oh. Raven, something men do that could turn any girlfriend into a psycho girlfriend.
I'm gonna say not pay her any attention.
What do you mean?
Like ignore her?
Ignore her!
Good answer, good answer, good answer.
How you doing?
I'm good, how you doing?
Quavers?
Yes, sir.
Now, this your wife?
This my wife.
What did you say?
To her.
To her.
So I'm gonna give you some free game today.
Right? Oh, here we go.
Free game. So this is what happened. We went to the same college.
Yeah.
Track runner, linebacker football player.
Yeah.
So football and track got out at the same time. So it was always a rush to the calf. So she always would steal my parking spot. So one day I walked into the cafeteria and I was like, you know, who keeps stealing my parking spot? She was like, it was her. So I hit her with the line like, stop stealing my spot, let me steal your heart.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Free game, yeah. Free game.
Yeah. It didn't even bother you that she was in your spot.
It really didn't, that's just a conversation piece.
Yeah, that's the lead in. You just need your foot in the door.
There you go.
You knew who it was before you asked. Who keeps stealing?
We had the same car, so I already knew who it was.
Oh, y'all had the same kind of car?
Yeah.
So you walked in the room and went, which one of y'all keeps stealing my spot?
Right.
So what'd you run? 200, 220, mm-hmm. Quarter?
Oh, I run 400 hurdles.
Ooh, Lord Jesus. Oh, ooh. Ooh, you a bad girl. Ooh. 400 with them sticks? All right. My man, name something men do that could turn any girlfriend into a psycho girlfriend.
Stay out all night or stay out all times of the night.
Stay out all night. We got two strikes. Come on, Courtney. Blanco family can steal. Name something men do that could turn any girlfriend into a psycho.
He better not put his hands on me and hit me.
He better not put his hands on me. Name something men do that can turn any girlfriend into a psycho girlfriend.
He better not talk about my weight.
Nope.
What else, Nicole?
I'm a psycho.
Better not talk about my weight. Number eight. Six.
Snore.
Number five. Three. Two. Top seven answers on the board. Here we go. If there is a stripper in your family, you just hope it's not your who?
Your mother.
Damn. Your mama. Well, Sarah, back again. If there's a stripper in your family, you just hope it isn't your who?
Grandma.
Your grandma. Grandma. Pam, there's a stripper in your family, you just hope it's not who?
Your spouse.
Your spouse.
Wife.
Dan, stripper in your family, you just hope it's not who?
Your father.
Your father. All right, we got no strikes. There's a stripper in your family. You just hope it isn't your who?
So I'm the oldest boy in my family. I just hope it's not my sister.
Yeah, can't be your sister. All right, come on, man. Here's your chance. If it's a stripper in your family, you just hope it's not your who?
Steve, I have a 5.5-year-old daughter, and I'm not casting any judgments, but I'm going to say my daughter.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, that would hurt me, man. Yeah. That would hurt me. My daughter. Yeah. One answer left. You got no strikes, Sarah. You guys are rolling. Last one's always a tough one, though. If there's a stripper in your family, you just hope it's not who?
Mother-in-law.
Your mother-in-law.
Good answer.
Pam, there's a stripper in your family, you just hope it's not who?
I hope it's not your cousin.
Not really all that close to my cousin. Cousin! This is a tough one. One answer left, Dan. Two strikes, though, the Campbell family can steal. There's a stripper in your family, just hope it isn't your who?
Your grandfather, Steve. Yeah.
Your grandfather. Grandfather. That was my answer. That's all I see left. If there's a stripper in your family, you just hope it isn't your who?
Well, Steve, we always have that aunt that's
that
doing some crap.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, come on.
Aunt. Name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
Bug bites.
Bug bites.
Heart attack.
Heart attack.
You see a lot of stuff in a nudist colony.
Treat a lot of people at the nudist colony, you take your clothes off and see yourself in the mirror, and you have a heart attack.
Oh. Okay, we're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Brian, name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
I'm gonna say thorn cuts.
Thorn cuts. Name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
I would say VD.
Yeah, VD. All right, let's go. Name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
Steve, I'm gonna say sunburn.
Sunburn. Jenna, name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
A urinary tract infection.
Urinary tract infection! All right, Savannah, name something a doctor in a nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
Poison ivy.
Poison, yeah. Poison ivy. One answer left. You can clear the board, buddy. No strikes. Something a doctor in the nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
I'm gonna say hypothermia.
Good answer.
Hypothermia. That's a good answer. That was a good answer. Only one answer left, but this time we gotta be careful. We got two strikes.
You got a mom?
The Gross family can steal. Name something the doctor in the nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
Boy. I'm gonna say. God. Stomachache.
Stomachache. Teresa, name something a doctor in the nudist colony treats a lot of patients for.
Erectile dysfunction.
Now, Teresa, you're in charge of this group.
I know.
You've told me that. You done let these four dudes.
They made me have to say that. I
know.
Don't talk
they
like that.
They gave you that answer.
They put me here, then I have to say that.
Well, Teresa, it should be up there. Erectile dysfunction. Number six.